Namaste students, I Sunanda Jain welcome you all to this video session, first standard 6 social sciences. Today I am going to start a chapter from history section. But before starting the chapter, I would like to give you a brief introduction to history. At times, a number of questions arise in our mind quite naturally. Who am I? How does this society or the world work? To understand all these complex issues, we first need to know about how our society has evolved, how people lived in the past, and how our past has shaped the present. But how do we know about our past? The answer is history. By studying history, we can easily understand how the modern world came into existence over long centuries of development. So, our first chapter from history section is basically related to the term history, and the name of the chapter is Studying the Past. In this chapter, we will discuss about the parts of history and the various source materials or evidences available to study the past. History is record of people, places and events of the past arranged in a chronological order. The word history is derived from the Greek word historia, which means know this. That means to come to know. History is based on facts and not on imagination. It helps us to learn about the great people, culture, art and architecture of the earlier times. History motivates us to make the present world a better place to live in. Historians divide history into two parts: prehistory and history. What is prehistory? Prehistory refers to that period when the art of writing was unknown. Our information about prehistory depends upon the remains of tools, bones, pottery and weapons that have been excavated. We learn about the age of artifacts through carbon dating. Now, history. What is history? History refers to the period after the invention of writing, the written records, dates, names of places and people may be on bhojpatras, palm leaves or pillars are source of information. History is generally categorized into three periods, namely ancient, medieval and modern. Now, what are the source material to study the past? The source material can be divided into two categories: archaeological source materials and literary source materials. Archaeological source materials. Some materials of the past are buried deep under the earth. They are either discovered by chance or archaeologists dig certain places and find ancient inscriptions, coins, pots or buildings. The study of these remains tells the archaeologists about the religious, social and cultural condition of that time. For example, buildings excavated from Mohenjo-daro provide useful information about the Indus Valley civilization. The archaeological source materials are mainly inscriptions, coins, monuments, sculptures, paintings, articles of daily use and skeletons. What are literary source materials? All written records of the past are known as literary sources or manuscripts. They are very important for historians. Before the invention of paper, people wrote and write on dried palm leaves, bhojpatra, copper plates, etc. Okay, so dear students, this was all about your first chapter of history, studying the past. In my next video, I will discuss the different types of archaeological source material and literary source materials. So till then, goodbye.